Guys, this is the ultimate lasagna, the lasagna you've been waiting for. Sebastian, are you ready to introduce everyone to Daddy Masterpiece? Yeah? Oh yeah, you want it? Yeah? Oh yeah, come on guys, Sebastian is hungry. Let's make the lasagna together. Kiss, kiss. Sensational dish. Look at the inside. Look at the inside, look at that, look at the inside. Look. Hi and welcome to Vincenzo and Sebastian's plate. Today, what are we making, Sebastian? We made a beautiful lasagna, approved by Sebastian, approved by all of you. Well, he can't wait to eat. This lasagna, guys, it's sensational. We have six layers of full happiness. It's not a traditional Bolognese lasagna. It's lasagna how I like to make it, full of cheeses. Come on, explore this beautiful lasagna with me and Sebastian. To make a sensational lasagna, you need two important things. Time. You need to be patient. You need to take your time. This recipe doesn't take 5 minutes, okay? Make sure you have time when you make lasagna. Second, you need the right, perfect ingredients, okay? I don't want you to use shredded mozzarella. I don't want you to use any fake cheese or anything that you don't need to use in this recipe, okay? Only the best. All right, so we start from the meat. So I get 500 grams of veal, 500 grams of pork. You can use any meat that you like. You can do duck, you can do beef, you can do, you choose, okay? It's personal. Then we have one carrot cut into small pieces. Then we have one celery stick cut into small pieces. Then we need half onion chopped into pieces. If you wanna use the red onion, use the red onion. We are using homemade tomato sauce, homemade passata. If you want to learn how to make it from scratch, watch the video up here. We made this with Filippo, and these are handmade, homemade, from scratch. We need 1 glass of red wine. Use any red wine that you like, anything you have already opened in your house. Salt and pepper. To assemble the lasagna, we need 3 important cheeses, okay? The provolone cheese. I like the beautiful kick of the provolone. When it melts, it gives you the kick that you want. Oh yeah. Now in this recipe, I went way too far. Very fancy. I want to show off. I'm using buffalo mozzarella. Oh yeah. You can use fior di latte, nice and fresh fior di latte. If you can find it, you can use bocconcini as a last resort. But if you can find these cheeses in your city, just move out. And then we have pecorino cheese or parmigiano cheese. Needs to be grated. Another important ingredient that we do need is the béchamel sauce. Not too much, just a little bit. So what we need is 25 grams of butter, 25 grams of plain flour, 250 mils of milk, and a little bit of nutmeg. Last but not least, you need the lasagna sheet. And you must use fresh, made with eggs and flour. You can add a little bit of semolina, but trust me, do not use the dry one from the packet, from the shop. I've used it before, I made a mistake. The lasagna doesn't taste as good, let me tell you. If you've seen my reaction videos, you know what to start a lasagna with. The soffritto, the base of any sauces. So to do a soffritto, we get extra virgin olive oil, generous amount. We want the extra virgin olive oil to warm up a little, and then we add the carrots, the onion, and the celery. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna cook them for about 5 to 10 minutes until they become golden, moist, and the meat can get the beautiful flavors when you put them in there. You know, you want the ingredients to make love together. So when the sofrito is nice and done, we're gonna add the meat. Now what we want to do is we want to turn the meat a little bit gray before we add the wine. Break your meat, and this also helps not to get big chunks of meat when you have your lasagna. At this point, I'm going to add the wine, okay? So the wine gives the beautiful flavors. This is the time where you put wine. You do not put wine in the tomato sauce. You do not put wine after the milk. You don't put wine at the end, you put the wine now. Basically, the wine is joining the party just for 5 minutes. It gives the flavors and it disappears. No alcohol will be involved in this recipe. You don't want to use wine, just use water, or maybe use vegetable stock if you like, but wine is better. The meat right now, it's very moist. The flavors, sublime, marvelous. And as you can see, the wine disappeared. It's just a little bit in there. Time to put the sauce in, the homemade tomato sauce. Let's put it in, yeah. Guys, I'm keeping half bottle of passata for me for the end, because we will use this to cover the top part of the lasagna, right at the end. Guys, if I have any leftovers of this sauce, I put it in the fridge and I make a pasta within a few days, you know? So don't worry if you add more sauce, you know? It's not gonna be a waste, trust me. Let's put some salt and pepper. Okay, this is not a bolognese sauce. It's a semi-bolognese sauce. And we are only cooking this for 2 hours. It's plenty of time, and I really like it, okay? So what we do now, we cover it for the first hour because we wanna keep all the flavors in there. I want them to get to know each other. Guys, I wanna be honest with you. If I was a candle maker, I would be making a ragu flavor because I love this smell in my kitchen. Yeah, let's make béchamel sauce. To make béchamel sauce, a little pan, low heat, and we put the butter in there, okay? We want the butter to slowly, gently melt. When the butter melts, which will take no time, put the flour in there, and we stir. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna get some lumps, okay? So keep stirring until the flour disappears. So we're gonna add a little bit of milk at a time right now, a little bit, not too much. So we start with 1/4 of the 250, and we stir on a medium-low heat, okay? Don't be too rough with the béchamel. See how dense it becomes? See how thick? Look at that. Look how thick, okay? See that? So let's keep adding the milk. We always want this to stay moist. We don't want the béchamel to dry up. See that? Look. Oh my God, it's coming all together. As you can see, I'm not making too much. I'm not a big fan of a lot of béchamel sauce. I'm just using a little touch of béchamel to give that little extra flavor that we love. It's creamy, it's drying up a little bit. Let's put the rest of the milk. It is important you keep stirring. Stir, because if you don't stir, what's gonna happen is it's gonna get stuck to the pan and we have to start from scratch. So stir. After a couple of minutes, you get this thick consistency, and that's your béchamel. You don't have to make it too thick. It can be a little bit runny because it needs to go in the lasagna, and we don't want this to be too thick. But you can make a thick béchamel, it's up to you. Now, as we chop the pan, quickly put some nutmeg, some salt, stir to give flavors, and we are ready to use it. It's basically ready to use. Guys, look how fantastic this beautiful béchamel sauce looks. Look at that. Please write a comment below. Let me know, what dish do you like to use béchamel for? You know, what's your favorite dish to use with béchamel? After 1 hour, remove the lid, and this is the sauce that we have, see? The reason why I do the first hour with the lid is because I'm not adding any water. I just wanna get the tomato to reduce as much as possible, like this, see? But because it's covered, it's not gonna dry up. But you do need to stir often. We're gonna use a standard glass of water, and now this water is gonna prevent for the sauce to burn, okay? But we need to stir this for the next hour. We stir, and if you feel like you do need more water, you add more water, okay? On a medium low heat, we keep cooking this gently, and then in 1 hour we are ready to assemble the lasagna. After 2 hours, look what we have. Have a look. Yum. Look at that. Look at this sauce. We are now ready to switch off the stove and assemble this masterpiece. Guys, to assemble the lasagna, I'm using a clear Pyrex here so I can show you the inside, how it's gonna look like. Now, what I like to do so we avoid for the lasagna to get stuck, I'm gonna put some extra virgin olive oil in there, or you can use butter if you want. And I'm gonna spread extra virgin olive oil everywhere, especially on the sides. Guys, I put too much oil in this dish, okay? I got excited. So just put less, please. Don't be too excited like me. Now, my pasta sheets are very large. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to cut them enough so they will fit in my size dish. But if you're using a large dish for a big family, then this size lasagna sheets are perfect. Okay, let's start by adding some tomato sauce at the bottom. Not too much, don't go crazy. I add a little bit more here. Okay, here we have, I want to create about 5 layers of pasta sheet here. Let's see if we're capable of doing that. Now, meat sauce. How much meat sauce do we need to use? Not too much, guys, because you don't want to have a steak sandwich here, you know? You want the meat just to be there. But every single ingredient needs to be added in moderation. Otherwise, they are overpowering. You know, you don't want to take away the beautiful flavors of the cheese, or take away the flavors of the meat, or take away the béchamel. You want to make sure you can taste all of them. Now here we have the trio of cheeses. We start by adding the pecorino cheese. We're going to put the provolone everywhere. I've got the buffalo mozzarella over here. So we're gonna break it. Look at the beautiful cream. And we just spread it everywhere, like if you're doing a pizza here, okay? Look at that, beautiful and creamy. And we keep the rest for after. Now it's time to add the béchamel sauce that we kept out of the fridge at room temperature. We just want to put a little bit, you know, no, don't go crazy. Just want to put like little lines here, just like that. Now we create the other layer. Now everyone thinks, oh, okay, I'm gonna put more meat on top and more cheese. No, what Vincenzo's plate does, I've got some beautiful, you know, basil sauce over here. Nice, simple basil sauce, which is just with onion, basil, carrots. And what I do is I put it on top, okay? I just put it on top. So we're gonna cover this lasagna with no cheese on top for now. Just tomato sauce over there. I'll foil. You cover it for 20 minutes. We're gonna cook this lasagna at 180 Celsius for 20 minutes in a flame forced oven. Guys, it's been 20 minutes and the lasagna is about to be revealed. Now I wanna show you this, okay? Let's take this off. Take it off slowly. Look what happens here, okay? Before we have a little bit of tomato sauce stuck to this. The reason why you don't wanna put the cheese is because the cheese will get stuck on this. You don't want to do that, okay? So now we have this beautiful top of lasagna, perfectly cooked. And what we do, we're gonna be very generous now with the pecorino cheese, okay? Right on top, be generous. And this will melt into the sauce. Now, back in the oven without any foil, for 10 more minutes. You know why I said to use top quality ingredients? Because I want you to enjoy this baby the way it is. Look how stunning. Look at that beautiful pecorino cheese melting on top. Look at the edges here. Look at that. A little bit of crunch. I made mistakes in the past, especially when I was filming videos where I basically cut it and served. I'm gonna wait as long as it takes until this lasagna cooled down. It's nice and warm. And then we can have it. The time has arrived. It's getting darker here. It's almost dinner time. This lasagna needs to be cut. Guys, this is the best part of the video recipe. Time to eat. Let's cut it, let's reveal this lasagna. Let's see how it looks inside. Oh yeah, look at that. Yeah, look at this cheese. Oh my God, it's a large amount of cheese. So moist. It melts in my mouth, look. This lasagna, in a way, it's light, but it melts in my mouth. Look at that. Oh, piece of provolone went back in the plate. Guys, sensational dish. Look at the inside. Look at the inside. Look at that. Look at the inside. Look. Look at the layers here. You got layers of cheese, meat, passion, and of course, love. What are you waiting for? Thank you so much for watching this episode. We will see you in the next Vincenzo's Plate video recipe. E ora si mangia. Vincenzo's Plate. Oh, it's lasagna time. Oh, love it. I've been waiting so long to share this video with you. Finally, I filmed it and I shared it. Oh, so happy. I'm so happy.